गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, माई सेल्फ श्री के डी बोरसे सर, अ बायोलॉजी सब्जेक्ट टीचर. इन लास्ट लेक्चर वी डिटेल डिस्कस रिप्रोडक्टिव हेल्थ एंड बर्थ कंट्रोल. नाउ टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न इन डिटेल बर्थ कंट्रोल. So let us start today's first concept known as birth control and Indian population relation. You know, approximately 350 million at the time of independence, Indian population reached close to a billion mark by 2000. Crossed 1.2 billion in May 2011. Now in 2020, population of India has crossed 1.35 billion. So how population growth from independence to 2020, today's current year, seen here. Very large amount of population grew from independence to current year. The government is taking serious measure to check or control this population growth. The most important step to overcome this problem is to motivate society to have smaller families by using various birth control method. One of the most important overcome this problem is to motivate society to have smaller families by using various birth control methods. So let us start, we detail discuss various birth control methods. What is actually birth control? A variety of methods are known for birth control, which is used for prevent fertilization. Each and every birth control method purpose prevent fertilization, avoid fertilization, prevent pregnancy, avoid pregnancy. Birth control measure also referred to as contraceptives, means contraceptive also called as birth control measure. The contraceptive methods help to prevent unwanted pregnancy. Now the most contraceptive should be easily available, effective, with no or least side effect. Different characteristics of contraceptive noted here. Contraceptives should be easily available, effective, no or least or very less side effects in. These are the characteristics of contraceptive. Now contraceptive methods are of two main types. First one is temporary method and second one is permanent method. So we will detail discuss one by one. First one is temporary method. In temporary method include different types, like different types of temporary contraceptive methods include total 7 types. Number 1 is natural method, safe method or rhythm method. Natural method, safe period, rhythm method is the first temporary contraceptive method. Second one is coitus interruptus or withdrawal. Third one is lactational amenorrhea और एब्सेंस ऑफ मेंस्ट्रुएशन, फोर्थ वन इज केमिकल मीन्स स्पर्मिसाइड्स, फिफ्थ वन मैकेनिकल मीन्स बैरियर्स मेथड, सिक्स्थ वन इज फिजियोलॉजिकल और ओरल डिवाइसेस, एंड लास्ट सेवन वन इज अदर कॉन्ट्रासेप्टिव. सो ऑल दिस टोटल सेवन डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ टेम्पररी कॉन्ट्रासेप्टिव मेथड्स वी डिटेल डिस्कस वन बाय वन. फर्स्ट वन इज नेचुरल मेथड, सेफ पीरियड रिदम मेथड इज वन ऑफ द टाइप ऑफ टेम्पररी कॉन्ट्रासेप्टिव मेथड. इन नेचुरल मेथड सेफ पीरियड रिदम मेथड इज अ नेचुरल मेथड स्पेशली फॉर अवॉइडिंग फर्टिलाइजेशन. द मेन पर्पज ऑफ दिस मेथड इज अवॉइडिंग फर्टिलाइजेशन. हाउ अकर्स दिस मेथड? अ वीक बिफोर एंड अ वीक आफ्टर मेंस्ट्रुअल ब्लीडिंग इज कंसिडर्ड सेफ पीरियड फॉर सेक्शुअल इंटरकोर्स और कॉपुलेशन. अ वीक बिफोर एंड अ वीक आफ्टर मेंस्ट्रुअल ब्लीडिंग इज कंसिडर्ड सेफ पीरियड फॉर सेक्शुअल इंटरकोर्स और कॉपुलेशन. दिस मेथड इज द आइडिया इज बेस्ड ऑन फॉलोइंग फैक्ट. ओवुलेशन ऑकर्स ऑन 14th डे ऑफ मेंस्ट्रुअल साइकिल. यू नो ओवुलेशन, लिबरेशन ऑफ ओहम और सेकेंडरी ओसाइट फ्रॉम ग्राफाइन फॉलिकल कॉल्ड एज ओवुलेशन इज ऑकर्स इन 14th डे ऑफ मेंस्ट्रुअल साइकिल. सो ऑन दिस बेस अ वीक बिफोर एंड अ वीक आफ्टर मेंस्ट्रुअल ब्लीडिंग is the safe period for sexual intercourse. Means during this, means a week before and a week after menstrual bleeding, during this period if sexual intercourse takes place, copulation takes place, fertilization is not occurs because of the fact is ovulation occurs 14th day. So before 14th day, if sexual intercourse occurs, not fertilization process takes place, and after 14th day, the egg is transferred to ampulla, and in the ampulla location, egg, spermate, fertilization process takes place. So egg and sperm life span is about 3 days. So after 3 days means 15, 16, 17. So after 17th day is also safe period for sexual intercourse. So after 17th day sexual intercourse takes place, fertilization is not occur. So week before and a week after menstrual bleeding is considered safe period for sexual intercourse, and this is the natural method, safe period for intercourse, rhythm method, and it is a type of temporary contraceptive method. But this method has some drawbacks. What is drawback of this method? Having a high rate of failure seen in this method. Always remember, having a high rate of failure this method. So up to this we detail discuss natural method, safe period rhythm method is one of the temporary contraceptive method. Now second one is coitus interruptus or withdrawal. This is also one of the temporary contraceptive method. In this method, the male partner withdraws his penis from the vagina just before ejaculation so as to avoid insemination. So here in this method, male partner withdraws his penis from vagina just before ejaculation so as avoid insemination, means semen is not enter into the vagina if the withdraws his penis from vagina just before ejaculation. You know, a single ejaculation contain 2 to 4 ml semen, contain millions of sperm. So such semen is not enter into the vagina if the male partner withdrawal his penis from vagina just before ejaculation. So due to this, avoids insemination, and avoid insemination is resulting prevent fertilization or avoid fertilization. So coitus interruptus or withdrawal is one of the temporary contraceptive method. This method is also some drawbacks. If the pre-ejaculation fluid contains sperms, can cause fertilization. So the penis release pre-ejaculation fluid. If the pre-ejaculation fluid contains sperms is present, can cause fertilization. So also the drawback of failure fertilization. Now here we detail discuss coitus interruptus or withdrawal is one of the temporary contraceptive method. Now the third one is lactational amenorrhea, absence of menstruation. This process, this method is based on the fact that ovulation does not occur during the period of intense lactation. Ovulation does not occur during the period of intense lactation as long as the mother breastfeeds the child fully chances of conception or pregnancy are almost negligible. Means as long as mother breastfeed the child fully at that duration, ovulation does not occur. So ovulation is not occurs, ovum or secondary oocyte is not released from graafian follicle. So due to this, not fertilization process takes place, and if not fertilization process takes place, prevent pregnancy, prevent fertilization. So the fact ovulation does not occur during the period of intense lactation, and during this period the chances of conception or pregnancy are almost negligible. However, this method is also drawbacks, high chances of failure. This method is also high chances of failure seen, but this is one of the type of temporary contraceptive method. Up to this we detail discuss lactational amenorrhea, absence of menstruation, especially based on ovulation does not occur during the period of intense lactation. So ovulation is not takes place, ovum or secondary oocyte is not released, ovum, secondary oocyte प्रिवेंट फर्टिलाइजेशन और अवॉइड फर्टिलाइजेशन. नाउ द फोर्थ वन इज केमिकल मीन्स और स्पर्मिसाइड्स. स्पर्मिसाइड मीन्स स्पर्म किलिंग केमिकल. यू नो इंसेक्टिसाइड इंसेक्ट किलिंग केमिकल, हर्बिसाइड हर्ब किलिंग केमिकल. सो हियर स्पर्मिसाइड मीन्स स्पर्म किलिंग केमिकल. इन दिस मेथड केमिकल्स लाइक फोम, टैबलेट, जेलीज एंड क्रीम्स आर डिफरेंट फॉर्म्स ऑफ द केमिकल्स. सो दिस केमिकल्स आर यूज्ड बाय फीमेल पार्टनर. ऑलवेज नोट एट दिस पॉइंट द केमिकल मीन्स और स्पर्मिसाइड्स आर यूज्ड बाय फीमेल पार्टनर. Before sexual intercourse, if these chemicals means foams, tablet, jellies and creams are the form of chemicals. So before sexual intercourse, if these chemicals are introduced into vagina or application into vagina, adhere to the mucous membrane. So this chemical is adhere to the mucous membrane and due to this immobilize and kill the sperms. Simply by chemical the sperm kill. So in this method called as spermicide, how it occurs before sexual intercourse, these chemicals are introduced into vagina or application into vagina. This chemical adhere to mucous membrane and immobilize to kill the sperms. You know, during the copulation or intercourse, a single ejaculation contain 2 to 4 ml semen, contain millions of sperm. So at the time of sexual intercourse, such millions of sperm enter into the vagina. If the vagina introduce such chemicals, so these chemicals are action on the sperm. So all the sperms get killed. So all sperm is killed. Fertilization process is not takes place. So this method is also prevent fertilization, avoid fertilization, and due to prevent fertilization, pregnancy is not occurs. This method has some drawbacks. It may cause allergic reaction because of the chemicals are introduced into vagina, so female partner cause allergic reaction is one of the drawback, and this method is also chances of failure. So up to this all four different temporary contraceptive methods we seen chances of failures. This method is also chances of failure seen. Up to this we detail discuss chemical means spermicide. Now the fifth one is mechanical means barrier methods. In this method, with the help of barriers, the ovum and sperm are prevented from physical meeting. Means not meet ovum and sperm because of barriers. Means this method provide barriers, and due to barriers ovum or egg and sperm are not physically meeting. So prevent physically meeting, fertilization is not takes place. So this method provide mechanical barriers. We detail discuss what are the mechanical barriers. Mechanical barriers are of three types. First one is condom, is one of the device provide mechanical barrier. Diaphragm or cervical cap or valves is also one of the device mechanical barrier. And intrauterine device, IUTC short form, is also one of the mechanical barriers. So all these three different barriers are provided, prevented ovum and sperm physical meeting. So let us see how provide prevented ovum sperm physically meeting by condom, by diaphragm, cervical cap, and also by intrauterine devices. We detail discuss one by one. First one is condom is one of the mechanical barrier. You know, condom is a thin rubber sheath that is used to cover the penis of the male during the copulation, called as condom. A thin rubber sheath that is used to cover the penis of the male during the copulation, called as condom. So due to this, the ejaculated semen is not enter into the vagina. So this semen is enter only in the condom during the copulation. So fertilization is not takes place, means avoid fertilization, prevent fertilization. It prevent the entry of ejaculated semen into the female reproductive tract because a thin rubber sheath cover the penis of male. This can be prevent conception, means pregnancy, because of semen is not enter into the vagina. A simple and effective method has no side effect, means this method is very simple, very effective method, and has no side effect. So these are the different characteristics of this method, means use condom. And condom is one of the barrier. Nirodh, you know, in Marathi, Nirodh is most widely used contraceptive by males. So these Nirodhs are easily available and is given by free by government is also so. Easily available and given by free government, provide different couples, is also one of the way of RCH program, and the RCH goal achievement way. It should properly discarded after every use, is must be essential. It should be properly discarded after every use. And condom is also a safeguard against sexual transmit diseases, means STDs, and also AIDS. So condom is most important for the STD as well as AIDS because the safeguards. So always remember, condom is safeguard against the STD and AIDS. Up to this we detail discuss first mechanical barrier known as condom. Now the second one is diaphragm, cervical cap or vault is one of the mechanical barrier. How prevent fertilization? Diaphragm, this devices used by the female partner. Always remember, diaphragm, cervical cap, device used by female are made up of rubber. This is diagrammatic representation. Here seen, this one is a diaphragm or cervical cap. This diaphragm or cervical cap is prevented to fertilization process. How occurs? The device is inserted into female reproductive tract to cover the cervix part. You know, cervix is one of the part of uterus. So this device inserted into female reproductive tract to cover the cervix during the copulation. So the semen is not enter into the female reproductive tract. So avoid fertilization process, prevent fertilization process due to diaphragm is inserted into female reproductive tract to cover the cervix during the copulation or intercourse process. This method prevent conception, means pregnancy is not takes place, or prevent pregnancy by blocking the entry of sperm through the cervix. Due to this, prevent fertilization, and due to prevent fertilization, prevent conception or pregnancy. So diaphragm or cervical cap is used by female partner, and it is one of the mechanical means or barrier is seen. Now the third one is mechanical means or barrier known as intrauterine devices, UIDs. It is a clinical device. Note at this point, this one is clinical device, are plastic or metal object, means it made by plastic or metal. So plastic or metal objects, a doctor or trained nurse placed the UIDs, means intrauterine devices, into the uterus. Always remember this point, intrauterine devices are fitted by a doctor or trained nurse. Therefore, this device called as clinical device. Up to this, other devices is not clinical devices. They are used by male partner as well as female partner, but this device is specially fitted by doctor or trained nurse, so it is called as clinical device and made by plastic or metal object. These devices include Leaves loops is one of the device. Second, copper releasing intrauterine devices contain CUT, means copper T, also CU7, also multi-lobed 375. So CUT, CU7, multi-lobed 375 are the copper releasing intrauterine devices. Noted this point. And number third one is hormone releasing intrauterine devices like LNG20 are hormone releasing device, and also Progestar-SERT is also hormone releasing device. So here total three different devices noted. Leaps loop is one of the intrauterine device, copper releasing intrauterine device, hormone releasing intrauterine device. So let us start one by one in detail. First one is Leaps loop is one of the intrauterine device. You know, intrauterine device is, first one is Leaps loop, a plastic double S shape loop, a plastic double S shape loop is attract the macrophages, stimulating them to accumulate in the uterine cavity, and due to this macrophages increases in the uterus, and macrophages increases in uterus, such macrophages phagocytosis to sperm. Phagocytosis means eating. You know, all macrophages have phagocytosis nature. So by phagocytosis action, the uterus contain all sperms by 10 macrophages. So due to this, all sperms are dilated into the uterus. So fertilization process is not occurs. Due to this, prevent fertilization or avoid fertilization. This phagocytosis process is occurs in the uterus, so it is acts as contraceptive. So Leaps loop is one of the contraceptive, especially in intrauterine device. Seen here diagrammatic representation, this is the double S shape loop known as Leaps loops, and this Leaps loops is fitted into the uterus, and due to this stimulate to attract macrophages, and due to attract macrophages, increasing the macrophages inside the uterus, and due to this, the increasing number of macrophages are phagocytosis of all the sperms in the uterus, and due to this, all sperms are dilated in the uterus, so fertilization process is not occurs, and due to fertilization process is not occurs, prevent fertilization seen and avoid fertilization. So Leaps loop is acts as contraceptive. Now here we detail discuss Leaps loops is one of the intrauterine device. Now the second one is copper releasing intrauterine device. It is one of the intrauterine device suppress sperm motility and also suppress fertilizing capacity of the sperms. Here sin, copper T, you know it is a metal object, T-shaped structure. Sin, this T-shaped structure, copper T is fitted in the uterus by special doctor or trained nurse. Here sin diagrammatic representation, this is a female reproductive system. You know female reproductive system consists of uterus, this one is uterus part, and inside the uterus this device is fitted in the perfectly as both ways is closed sin in the uterus, and due to this copper T present in uterus, fertilization is avoided. Sperm is not transferred to the ampulla site, and also the egg is not fertilized, and the egg, if egg is fertilized, the blastocyst is not enter into the uterus. So this device is specially for suppress sperm's mortality and fertilizing capacity of the suppress fertilizing capacity of the sperm. Drawbacks of some UIDs. What are the drawbacks? Spontaneous expulsion sin is one of the drawback of copper releasing intrauterine devices. If this devices is expulsion from this place, so this is one of the drawback, and also occasional hemorrhage, and due to this chances of infection. If this metal object is touched to uterine wall, so at that place infection takes place, and infection takes place means bleeding takes place, means hemorrhage seen here, and this is also one of the drawback of intrauterine devices. So here we detail discuss up to this all intrauterine devices. Each one is provide fertilization prevention or fertilization avoided situation, so pregnancy is not takes place, pregnancy prevention or avoided pregnancy situation by all these intrauterine devices. Now the sixth number type of temporary contraceptive device known as oral device or physiological device. In physiological device or oral device are used in the form of tablets and hence are popularly called as pills. You know pills means tablets, so pills are physiological or oral devices. It is an oral contraceptive used by female partner. Always remember, physiological or oral devices are used by female. The pill contain progesterone and estrogen hormones. You know, progesterone and estrogen hormone. So these hormones are present in the pill. You know, pill is also chemical tablet, so inside it the chemical is progesterone and estrogen. They inhibit ovulation process. You know, ovulation means liberation of ovum from graafian follicle. So this method is inhibit, prevent ovum or secondary oocyte is not released, and due to this prevent fertilization and avoid fertilization. So due to avoid fertilization, pregnancy is prevented. Hence the egg released from ovary is not takes place from female. Using this pill, conception cannot occurs, means pregnancy cannot occurs. They also altered the quality of cervical mucus. Inside the cervix contain mucus, quality is altered because of pill chemicals. Due to this, to prevent the entry of sperm, and if the prevent entry of sperm, fertilization process is not occurs. Now physiological devices are used in the form of tablet and hence are popularly called as pills. So the pill Saheli, in Marathi the pill Saheli, an oral contraceptive for especially female, so which is non-steroidal nature, means steroid is completely absent in the pill. Saheli is to be taken once in a week. Always remember, this tablet is taken once in a week, female partner especially. This pill are sponsored by the government. This is also noted point. Saheli is one of the pill oral contraceptive for female, and this pill is sponsored by government, and this tablet or Saheli is taken once in a week, noted point. You know, this is the Saheli pocket, and inside it these tablets are called as Saheli pills. Some side effects of the pills. The pills have side effects like nausea, regurgitation, seen one of the side effect, weight gain due to this tablet. Weight gain seen, such mother, tenderness of the breast is also seen in such mother, and slightly blood lost between the menstrual period is also seen. So all these four different side effects seen due to these pills is always remember. But the pill Saheli is one of the physiological oral device. Now always remember, Saheli is now a part of National Family Program as an oral contraceptive pill in India. Always remember, which one is oral contraceptive pill in India? Saheli. So Saheli is now a part of National Family Program. Always remember, this is the Saheli pocket contain these pills are Saheli pills. Always remember, Saheli is National Family Program part, and it is a oral contraceptive pill in India. Now the last type of temporary contraceptive method is other contraceptives. The birth control implant is the contraceptive device. It is contraceptive used by female, means birth control implant is a contraceptive used by female partner. Always remember, this device is also used by female partner, and this device is a teeny thin rod size of match stick. You know match stick? So it is a teeny thin rod size match stick is implanted under the skin of upper arm of the female partner. Always remember, it is a teeny thin rod size of match stick, and this thin rod match stick size teeny part is implanted, means introduced, under the skin of upper arm of female partner by special doctor. So due to this, here seen, this is a stick present on hand, and this stick is birth control implant. So this stick is very teeny thin rod match stick size implanted under the skin of upper arm of the female partner, seen here, implanted upper arm female partner, this position implanted this stick called as birth control implant. So what are the characteristics of birth control implant actual? They contain, means the birth control implant contain or teeny thin rod contain progesterone and estrogen hormones. So their mode of action similar to pills. You know, pills contain also progesterone and estrogen. So their mode of action is similar to pill, same work as pill is birth control implant. They prevent pregnancy. If such birth control implant implanted under the skin of upper arm of female member, so they prevent pregnancy for 3 to 4 years. Always remember noted point, how many year prevent pregnancy after birth control implant in the implanted under the skin upper arm of female member? 3 to 4 years. Noted point. Now up to this we detail discuss all the types of temporary contraceptive methods. You know, total 7 different types of temporary contraceptive methods we detail discuss in today's lecture. Now permanent method. The permanent method, birth control have the permanent birth control method in main is vasectomy, and second one is the permanent birth control method in women is tubectomy. So vasectomy and tubectomy are the two permanent methods specially for different sex in men vasectomy and in women tubectomy. So both permanent birth control methods are surgical methods. Also, sterilization means those male and female person is sterilized person after these techniques, vasectomy in male and tubectomy in female, that is woman. Now we detail discuss one by one vasectomy and tubectomy. Now we detail discuss vasectomy. First one is vasectomy. What is vasectomy? Permanent birth control method in men is vasectomy. It is surgical method also called as sterilization. How occurs vasectomy? A small part of the vas deferens. You know vas deferens? It is a accessory duct of male reproductive system. You know, we detail discuss different accessory duct of male reproductive system. Yes, rhetatis is vas afferentia, epididymis, vas deferens, ejaculatory duct and urethra. So a small part of the vas deferens of male reproductive system is tied and cut. Such surgical operation called as vasectomy. So in vasectomy surgical operation, vas deferens part tied and cut process. This is the male reproductive system. You know, this one is epididymis and lower part of epididymis is continuous. Vas deferens open into the urethra. So this vas deferens is cut, tied and cut it at a location here seen. Also this side is also vas deferens tied and cut. So this vas deferens tied and cut surgical operation called as vasectomy. You know, due to this means vasectomy, the sperm is formation process takes place inside the testis, contains seminiferous tubules. So the sperm is transferred from seminiferous tubule to rete testis to vas afferentia to epididymis and then transfer to vas deferens and then it transfer to urethra. So this is the way of sperm or pathway of the sperm. So if the vas deferens tied and cut at this location, the sperm is not transported forward direction. So due to this, the male person released semen is absent of the sperms. So due to this, fertilization cannot occur, pregnancies cannot occur. So vasectomy is main purpose is blocks gametes transport. Sperm is one of the gametes, so block gamete transport and prevent pregnancy. Here specially sperm block transportation. So prevent pregnancy is the main purpose of vasectomy. So up to this we detail discuss here what is actual vasectomy and how it occurs. Also with the help of diagram scene, vast difference, tide, cut, location, main purpose of vasectomy, detail discuss. Now, second one is tubectomy. You know, tubectomy is also a permanent birth control method in woman. Is tubectomy. It is surgical method also called as sterilization. What is actually tubectomy? Tubectomy means a small part of fallopian tube. You know, fallopian tube is one of the accessory duct of female reproductive system, also called as oviduct, also called as uterine tube. So fallopian tube, a small part is tied and cut. Such surgical operation called as tubectomy. Let me show with the help of figure seen here. This is the female reproductive system, and this female reproductive system consists of different parts. So this is the uterus part, and this one is oviduct or fallopian tube. Same seen in right left side is also. So fallopian tube or oviduct consists of three parts: infundibulum, ampulla, and isthmus. This isthmus is open into the uterus. So at the isthmus location of fallopian tube, tied and cut it right side as well as left side. So this fallopian tube tied and cut it, surgical operation called as tubectomy. Simply fallopian tube is tied and cut, called as tubectomy. Tubec means tube and tomy means cut, so called as tubectomy. And the main purpose of tubectomy is same as vasectomy, like blocks gametes, transport and prevent pregnancy. So both vasectomy or tubectomy, the main purpose is blocks gametes, transport and prevent pregnancy. Here the gamete is ovum or egg is block. So block gamete transport, that is prevent fertilization, avoid fertilization. Due to avoid fertilization, prevent pregnancy process. So here we detail discuss tubectomy, and up to this we detail discuss permanent birth control method in men, vasectomy, and in women, tubectomy. Hope that you understood everything up to this. Today's lecture completed. Review today's topics. We detail discuss today birth control and Indian population relation, also birth control methods, main two types of contraceptive, temporary method and permanent methods. Different seven types of temporary contraceptive methods, like first one is natural method, safe method, rhythm method, second coitus interruptus or withdrawal, third lactational amenorrhea or absence of menstruation, chemical means spermicide, fifth one is mechanical means or barriers methods. In that, mechanical barriers of three types, like first one is condom, second one is diaphragm or cervical cap and valves, and third one is intrauterine devices. in intrauter and devices contain. First one is LIPS loop, second one is copper releasing intrauter and devices CUT CU7 multilobed 375 and hormone releasing intrauter and devices like LNG20 and also progress starts. Physiological oral devices is the sixth temporary method, contain pills, Saheli, other contraceptive devices, birth control implant, and permanent method contain two terms, vasectomy especially for in men and tubectomy especially for women. So today we detail discuss all these concepts on the basis of today's lecture, some exercise question noted here. The oral contraceptive pill, which is now a part of National Family Program in India, yes, Saheli is oral contraceptive pill, which is now a part of National Family Program in India. What is the main purpose of vasectomy and tubectomy? Yes, block the gamete transportation and prevent pregnancy. What is the role of birth control pill? Prevent ovulation is the main role of control pills, birth control pills. Name two temporary methods of birth control which have high chances of failure. Yes, natural method, safe period, rhythm method is one of the temporary method, and also lactational amenorrhea, absence of menstruation, is the second temporary method. Different between vasectomy and tubectomy. You know, vasectomy is specially for men and tubectomy is specially for women. In vasectomy, vas deferens tied and cut a small part, and in tubectomy, fallopian tube, a small part of fallopian tube is tied and cut. So both are surgical operations. Men vasectomy block the sperm gamete transportation, and in tubectomy especially women block the egg as a gamete transportation. Now, how many year prevent pregnancy by contraceptive like birth control implant? Yes, 3 to 4 year prevent pregnancy. Which one is mechanical means is the safeguard against STD and AIDS? Yes, condom is one of the mechanical means, is a safeguard against the sexual transmitted diseases and AIDS. Here one MCQ question noted, which of the is hormone releasing UID? LIPS loop, CU7, LNG20, multilobed 375. So correct answer is LNG20 is the hormone releasing intrauterine device. MCQ question is also, Saheli, an oral contraceptive pill, is to be taken daily, weekly, quarterly, monthly. The correct answer is weekly. Sayali is an oral contraceptive pill, is taken weekly, is the correct answer. Up to this, today's lecture completed. Hope that you understood everything. Today's lecture was very clear to you. If you like the video, then you can subscribe my YouTube BioInfo channel. Tap the bell icon and like the video. If any doubt about today's lecture, mention in comment box. Thank you.